Our next story is from Ukraine. It concerns the country's president, Volodymyr Zelensky, the poster boy of the West's resistance against Russia. The embodiment of defiant bravery for Europe and its allies. That's exactly what they called him when Russia had invaded Ukraine. But do they treat him as such? Not really. A new report shared some interesting insights on how the West treats Volodymyr Zelensky, especially the United States, a country which promised to do whatever it takes to help Ukraine. Turns out it is, but not without condensation. According to one report, Biden recently lost his temper during a phone call with Zelensky. Why? Because he felt Zelensky wasn't showing enough gratitude. The phone call took place in June. It was about a new financial aid package, a $1 billion package of military aid. Zelensky apparently wanted more. So he started to list out the additional help he needed, but wasn't getting. And this is when the American president reportedly lost his temper. He raised his voice to remind Zelensky how generous the Americans were being and how Zelensky could show a little more gratitude to them. Now, before I go further, let me make this very clear. These are reports at best. They may or may not be true, but as they say, there's no smoke without fire. So what this supposed clash reflects is a kind of pressure that the US president is currently under for sending billions of dollars to Ukraine at the expense of the American taxpayer. That's what analysts are saying, and not without reason. Look at the headline on your screen now. Biden is facing incredible resistance from both Republicans and Democrats on congressional support to Ukraine. In fact, just last week, a group of 30 so-called progressive Democrats sent a letter to Biden vis-a-vis his Ukraine strategy. They asked him to pursue direct engagement with Russia and stop spending enormous amounts of money to keep the war going. Allow me now to quote their statement. As legislators responsible for the expenditure of tens of billions of US taxpayer dollars in military assistance in the conflict, we believe that such involvement in this war also creates a responsibility for the United States to seriously consider all possible avenues, including direct engagement with Russia. That's not all. When the US State Department was asked to comment on the matter, this is what its spokesperson said. I'm quoting again. Right now, we have heard from Ukrainian partners repeatedly that this war will only end through diplomacy and dialogue. So what does this tell you? That there's a growing sentiment in America that the funding to Ukraine needs to be reassessed. At the same time, America should explore diplomacy and dialogue with the Russians. Remember, the timing of this report on the Biden-Zelensky call, also of what's unfolding in America, is very crucial. It's all happening in the run-up to the midterm polls. They're scheduled for the 8th of November. That's just a week from now. These elections are very important. They will determine which party controls the US Congress. The prospects of Democrats winning don't look good. They're trailing in most opinion polls. They're expected to lose their stronghold. And to add to their worries, Republicans have amplified their rhetoric on Ukraine, with some Republican leaders going as far as saying that there won't be a blank check for Ukrainians if they win control of the chamber from Democrats. Naturally, this has raised concerns that Republicans might choke, if not end, American aid to Ukraine altogether. So Team Biden is on tricky terrain here. They can't afford to lose these polls. So what do? They try to balance their narrative on Ukraine by banking on such tell-all reports on how Joe Biden supposedly told Zelensky to be a bit more thankful. Here's hoping it yields the desired results for them. Beyond World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news.